Hi, this is Mike Negami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. Today, we'll learn and practice the Ishikawa Diagram and the 5-Y analysis in the Excel template. Here are the steps. 1. Write down your problem statement. 2. Identify your large categories of process issues. 3. Break down each large categories into smaller categories or factors. 4. Highlight the direct factors for your problem statement and identify the root cause. In Lean Sigma projects, we always aim for a fundamental resolution instead of temporary solution. So it's essential to find root causes. Powerful tools for that are Ishikawa Diagram and the 5-Y analysis. Click the link in this video's description, then you can download the Ishikawa Diagram's Excel template. This is the Ishikawa Diagram's screen. It shows instructions here. Read them later. Because of its shape, it's called a fishbone diagram. Gather supervisors of the target process and have a brainstorming session. Step 1. Put your project's key problem statement in the head of the fishbone. In my case study project, our project chart shows the top reason for product return was customer's cause. We need to find out the root cause of that. Therefore, our problem statement will be why do customers return products with their own fault as the excuse. Put that in the yellow box. Step 2. Put a large category in each large bond box. The manufacturing industry has 4 M's as their framework for this: man, material, machine, and method. In service operations, however, the 4 M's are usually not applicable. Practically speaking, you have to start from asking, please tell us large category factors for the problem statement. Then exchange opinions freely, narrow them down to 4 to 6 at most. Then type them in each blue box. Step 3. Break down the large categories into smaller categories or factors. A great tool for this is the 5-Y analysis. For example, this large category is mistakes while taking orders. Then we'll ask why did mistake occur while taking orders. Likely responses might be an order was unclear or unnecessary orders were made and so on. Then ask why did that happen for each answer. Why was the order unclear? Why were unnecessary orders made? Repeat this at least 5 times. This is the 5-Y analysis. However, at this point, you should not be concerned about connecting causal relationship well. Rather, it's better to get many opinions. After all opinions were given, connect each answer by causal relationship. A large bone is a result and a medium bone is a cause. Then the medium bone is a result and small bone is a cause. You may have smaller bones. Put those relationships in the white boxes. To save time, let's assume that my team gained these answers here. I'll copy and paste them. If a text is long, enlarge the box by dragging the edge of the box. While pressing your shift key, click multiple boxes, then you can move them together. Also, while pressing your control key, drag box and release it. You can copy it very easily. Select only an arrow and drag only its top edge. You can change its length and direction. Do step 3 for all of the large categories. This is the completion of step 3. Step 4. Discuss which are direct root causes for the problem statement. Then highlight them. This is a root cause factor card. Use this as the highlight. This is now completed. The conclusion of this analysis is customers and sales reps didn't utilize the latest product catalog well. Therefore, our solution is to utilize the latest product catalog more effectively. Today, we learned how to make the Ishikawa diagram and the 5Y analysis. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.